mythology and the prophecy surrounding Planet X, this presentation will limit its focus to reviewing the most tangible, credible pieces of scientific evidence supported by astronomers and astrophysicists who in recent years have risked destroying their careers, their reputations, and their very lives promoting their controversial findings and conclusions. This year, more than ever, the movement's growing authenticity of the Planet X story is in fact gathering momentum and garnering support from some rather high-profile notables within the scientific community. This presentation will chronicle the growing body of empirical evidence validating not only Planet X's existence, but its imminent approach towards Earth. The highly controversial Planet X system entering our solar system with potential catastrophic implications was first featured in a Washington Post article back in 1983. NASA's infrared astronomical telescope found the mysterious planet, possibly as large as Jupiter, near the constellation of Orion. Now some 33 years ago, it was considered to be the closest heavenly body to the Earth beyond Pluto. Researcher-activist John Moore has long asserted that a number of his inside ex-military and government intelligence sources have independently confirmed that a top-secret meeting took place in 1979 in a New Orleans briefing room where highest-ranking U.S. naval flag officers were first informed of the coming inevitable Planet X disaster that would occur within their lifetime. In October 2003, a highly significant and telling Department of Defense-sponsored government paper was published called An Abrupt Climate Change Scenario and Its Implications for United States National Security. This paper notes that oceanic saline levels were dropping, causing thermohaline circulation collapse. A serious disruption of the Atlantic conveyor belt that pushes warm salt water near the surface circulating northward from the south, while deeper, cooler water flows southward, would have a devastating impact on global climate. The paper concludes with the following sobering predictions: wars over energy, food and water resources, increasing drought over wider landmass, and violent climate change effects producing more frequent, higher magnitude natural catastrophes of all kinds. A dozen years later, all of these most disturbing developments are clearly manifesting. Of course, the current standard politically correct scientific dogma is that global warming, aka climate change, emanating from CO2 greenhouse gases, is the obvious culprit. This mass deception is designed to conveniently obscure the multiple dire effects caused by many decades of the globalists' geoengineering, HARP, weather modification, and weather wars, not to mention the hidden, non-existent Planet X system hurtling towards us deeper inside our solar system that's likely causing tremendous changes at the surface of all our solar system planets, of course including our own Earth's atmosphere and global surface. In March 2010, the mainstream UK newspaper, The Telegraph, ran a story entitled "Search On for Death Star That Throws Out Deadly Comets." The subheadline announced that NASA is looking for the twin sun, that's the brown dwarf star Nemesis, slowly circling our sun and periodically catapulting deadly comets to the Earth. So as quiet as NASA has been over the years, little bits of information reflecting the notion that they are still searching for the cataclysmic Planet X system manages to seep through to the public every now and then from so-called reputable news sources. The article goes on to state that the star that's five times the size of Jupiter is the prime suspect that wiped out the dinosaur 65 million years ago, as the following video suggests.
Earth is believed to have undergone five official mass extinctions thus far, and one retired astrophysics professor thinks he knows what could have caused them. In a recently published study, Daniel Whitmire argues that presently undiscovered planet X is responsible for an onslaught of comets colliding into Earth every 27 million years or so, and destroying life, including the dinosaurs. In 1985, Whitmire released his first paper on this ninth planet, which theoretically exists along the outer bounds of our solar system. He and his co-author, John Matisse, reasoned that the orbit of planet X takes it through the Kuiper belt in 27 million year intervals, and objects get pushed to the inner solar system as a result. In his current research, Whitmire links these events with mass extinctions on Earth based on updated records of comet showers over the past 500 million years. Despite his argument, a Discovery News article on this topic expresses some skepticism. The writer Ian O'Neill wonders, for instance, if these bombardment events are necessarily caused by Planet X rather than other forces.
The NASA Wide Field Infrared Survey Explorer was capable of detecting the faint heat emanating from the dwarf star 25 times the distance between Earth and the Sun, or one-third a light-year away. Launched in January 2009, WISE discovered at least 1,000 dwarf stars located within 25 light-years from the Sun until October of 2010, when its coolant was scheduled to run out. With the Planet X system entering our solar system, its gravitational force is believed to launch trajectories of comets and asteroids that are large-sized space debris objects of icy rocks and dust that bombard our solar system planets, including the Earth. Professor John Matisse of the University of Louisiana Lafayette believes that the nemesis that includes planet Nibiru as part of the Planet X system is mainly responsible for supplying such a concentrated volley of comets from the Oort cloud into our inner solar system. In May 2012, LiveScience.com and Examiner.com, shown in this video slideshow, both featured headline stories heralding the probable discovery of Planet X. Astronomer Rodney Gomez of Rio's National Observatory of Brazil had just presented new evidence of the mysterious planet at a meeting of the American Astronomical Society. Gomez demonstrated that icy objects outside Neptune's orbit in the Oort cloud, displaying irregular movement that cannot be explained by known mathematical laws of astrophysics, but can be explained by the gravitational influence of so-called Planet X. In addition, the dwarf planet Sedna's peculiar orbit can also only be accounted for by the presence of a large unknown planet. Gomez's findings were very well received by his peers, believing that he got his math correct. But of course, not wanting to endorse Planet X completely, they quelled their enthusiasm with a call for more research and posing alternative theories that may not involve another large planet. In November of 2014, IFLScience.com reported evidence that two new undiscovered planets may be lurking in our solar system. A January 2015 article from Space.com also addressed the possibility of two more planets beyond Neptune and Pluto moving in the outer limits of our solar system and subtly influencing the orbits of the dwarf planets. Carlos de la Fuente of Madrid's University of Complutense stated, "This excess of objects with unexpected orbital parameters would have us believe that some invisible forces are altering the distribution of the orbital elements, of the extreme trans-Neptunian objects. And we consider that the most probable explanation is that other unknown planets exist beyond Neptune and Pluto. In March 2014, another team of astronomers, Chadwick Trejo and Scott Shepard, announced the discovery of 2012 VP113, another ETNO joining Sedna, as two known members of the inner Oort cloud, which is the comet-filled sphere that lies just beyond the Kuiper Belt and Pluto. Trejo and Shepard claim these two objects' orbits comply with the gravitational presence of a big disturber, which is up to 10 times the mass of the Earth. Major unheard-of changes are currently appearing on the surface and atmosphere of the Sun and all the planets. Astronomer Mike Lockwood from California's Rutherford Appleton National Laboratories found that since 1901, the Sun's overall magnetic field has increased by 230%. Solar flares and storms have also increased. The Earth's moon now has a 6,000 kilometer deep atmosphere of natrium that it never had before. Mercury, the planet closest to the Sun, now has grown polar ice. Venus's brightness has skyrocketed by 2,500% and experienced major changes in its atmosphere in the last four decades. Meanwhile, further away from the Sun than the Earth, Mars has melted polar ice caps, and its magnitude of storms has strengthened exponentially. Jupiter has had the brightness of its plasma clouds increase 200%, accompanied by a pattern of intermittent thickening, then weakening. The largest planet in our solar system's enormous belts have been changing color with radiation levels erratically waning and then flaring up again. An increase in asteroid and comet activity on Jupiter is likely from Nibiru's entrance into our solar system. During the last three decades, the jet stream on Saturn's equator has slowed in velocity, while X-rays at the equator have spiked. Uranus has become brighter with a huge flare-up of storm activity, when its surface before was always placid. Neptune has also increased in brightness by 40%. The atmospheric pressure on Pluto has jumped up by 300% despite it moving further from the Sun. The glowing plasma on the edge of our solar system has increased 1,000%. The profound changes being measured in space are unprecedented. An increase in energy emissions is changing the fundamental structure of all matter throughout our solar system. Taken together, these massive across-the-board changes most likely are all the result of Planet X moving through our solar system. Changes on the Earth have been pronounced as well, most notably with electromagnetic changes, yearly incremental polar axis changes, and extreme weather changes. As an example, North Pole, Alaska, recently saw its late spring temperatures soar to a high of 80 degrees Fahrenheit. Between 1963 and 2009, the frequency of natural disasters globally has leaped up by 410%. And in more recent years, the rate of disasters has soared even higher. With an increasing number of volcanic eruptions along the Pacific Ring of Fire, and earthquakes felt globally, particularly along the San Andreas and the New Madrid fault lines, major volcanic and earthquake activity is rapidly on the rise. As early as November 2013, 10 different long-dormant volcanoes went active, first suggesting Planet X's presence. The rate of volcanic eruptions between 1875 and 2010 has increased nearly 500%, but even greater now. A substantial increase in 3.0 or higher earthquakes are shaking America's heartland due to fracking. In Oklahoma alone, going from 2 or 3 a year prior to fracking to 562 last year alone. Since 1973, earthquakes have risen worldwide by 400%. 6.0 magnitude earthquakes or greater has also spiked in recent years, jumping on average from 108.5 earthquakes per year in the 1980 to 89 decade to 160.9 earthquakes per year from 2000 to 2009, increasing by 38.9%. In the first quarter of 2014 alone, more than twice as many large earthquakes occurred than on average since 1979. Last year, scientists at the European Science Foundation warned that in the years to come, there is a 5 to 10% chance that a colossal-sized volcano could send the Earth back to pre-civilization status. A significant rise in landslides and floods have also been measured. For the last 2,000 years, the Earth's magnetic field has been decreasing gradually. But in the last 500 years, that decrease has become much more dramatic. Scientists have been shocked at the alarming rate that the Earth's magnetosphere has been disappearing. The planet's natural shield preventing solar winds and radiation from reaching the Earth's surface is being lost. This disturbing discovery comes while solar storm activity continues. These solar blasts seriously threaten to interfere with satellite and GPS communications, and risk bursts of electromagnetic pulses, if not launched by EMP weapons in the wrong hands, like ICES, that could be lethal to America's power grid, quickly placing millions of people in the dark without any source of electricity for months or even years at a time. Effects from a diminishing magnetic field would double the amount of radiation, causing an epidemic of skin cancer deaths, speed up climate change, and magnify extreme weather. Solar winds would eliminate ions that allow the Earth to retain water and air. All these horrific changes are happening right now. This torrid rate of ecological degradation and life-threatening Earth surface changes are more than likely caused by Planet X racing ever closer toward us. Another rather peculiar development to the Planet X story has been Google Sky's strange actions. Several years ago, no doubt in keeping with the media blackout, Google actually did black out the grid in the sky to ensure that Planet X was eliminated from its sky map. Then about a year ago, Google Sky mysteriously reinserted the missing grid, fully depicting the flaming winged Nibiru. So it has now been visible from both the actual sky and the Google Sky this year. More evidence that the tide is turning toward the truth about Planet X. Just last month, the European Space Agency invited scientists from around the world to a conference in Prague to discuss the topic of an Earth observation strategy and its relevance to societal and economic changes that will occur. Of special interest in this particular symposium is that hazards to the Earth was the key theme of this meeting. In other words, drastic changes to the planet in the way of earthquakes, volcanoes, and floods, but also significant changes to the atmosphere, the cryosphere, and to the oceans. Does this symposium sound familiar to the Nibiru cataclysm scenario, minus the forbidden planet, of course? So now you have been provided with but a few of the more relevant scientific findings, which establish an acceptable hypothesis for the existence of a rogue system of planets, a mini constellation with its own star, a binary companion to our own sun, now hurtling through space within the confines of our solar system. Of course, you can easily dismiss these findings as nothing more than pseudoscience, if that is your belief. But if you take the time to examine the evidence that is provided, you will come to a clearer understanding of the changes that are happening to our planet, why they are happening so quickly and in such great numbers, and what is the mechanism by which these events are taking place within our solar system and here on planet Earth. The changes that are suddenly occurring on the planet may seem extraordinary to some of you, but the events that are unfolding today are the same events that happened thousands of years ago to ancient civilizations.
あれに送りましょうか。 Наверно, ти бачиш цього чорта одному. Зараз то з тої сторони буде валитися. Я в шокі.
莫兰蒂台风来袭，富冈渔港的浪创下有史以来的纪录，红色的灯塔也随之消失在惊涛骇浪中。
啊！这个岛已经是
这样，硬了呢。
哦，岛拢要头啊，这不是小比赛啊。
Because in the next few frames, we're going to see another sun halo 6 to 7 times larger. Now, 30 minutes of images were just removed from this section. So now we can only see the bottom of this enormous halo. The east-facing weather cam in Angoon, Alaska, shows something rising just above the horizon on the left. It casts its reflection upon the water. It may be interesting to realize that the sun is not in this image because the sun is rising in the northeast in Alaska, not in the east. And this camera is facing east. As we go through the video, look at the timestamp. Nearly 2.5 hours later, the sun appears from the north on the left side of the screen. The object we saw rising 2.5 hours ago was not the sun. It was something else. Here is the northeast weather cam in Angoon. The sun is rising near the center, and off to the right is the other celestial object we just saw rising in the last camera footage we looked at. If the clouds weren't so thick, we would see another celestial object rising to the left of the sun. The northeast facing weather cam captured a black indicator beam being emitted for an eclipse. These eclipses occur multiple times daily. Here's a common reflection that we see throughout Alaska and Canada, clouds permitting, of course. Notice the sun's reflection on the water. It's often in two different pieces. One is the sun, and the other is NASA's tiny but intense artificial light launched many miles from the Earth's surface, which tracks in sync with the sun. You can see the black center of that equipment easily in this image, but the black center is not always visible. This photo from the southwest-facing camera in Myers Chuck, Alaska, shows that black center of NASA's artificial light, and it's casting a reflection on the water. This reflection can be seen by anyone with or without a camera. The northeast-facing weather cam in Eagle, Alaska, picked up a very large, round object. Both the glare and the atmospheric chemicals make it very difficult to see. Look closely and you can see NASA's artificial light pass over it. This object passes in front of our sun, but behind NASA's artificial light, so that it's not obvious an eclipse is occurring. Since the object doesn't move, it could be one of NASA's large lenses. Here's a close-up of those frames. And here's a close-up with some contrast applied. Here is another enormous object. However, this one is moving with the sun, but not as fast as the sun, as you can see over the course of 40 minutes in this time-lapse video. Here's a close-up view of those four frames. And here are those four frames with contrast applied to the celestial object. The contrast works much better if sun and clouds are not included in the contrast. That's why I often apply the contrast to a small area of the screen. It really works much better that way. The southeast-facing weather cam located in Kotzebue captured the red planet that we frequently see. This red planet has a much faster rotation than our Earth or Sun. You must have an IQ of at least 75 to understand why this cannot be a lens flare. It is impossible for a lens flare to reflect faster rotations than the object creating the lens flare. Additionally, in the last frame of this video, clouds moved in and covered up the planet. If this were a lens flare, clouds could not cover it up because the lens flare is in the camera and not behind the clouds. Here's an interesting video from the east-facing weather cam in Kotzebue, Alaska. As the sun moves across the sky, the atmospheric chemicals have created somewhat of a veil appearance. It almost looks as if someone has whitewashed the sky around the perimeter of the sun or taken some paint or something. After a few frames, the red planet comes into view. It's very difficult to see amidst the atmospheric chemicals, but some contrast here helps to bring it into view. The objects we have just viewed are part of an approaching celestial system. Many people ask when the system will make its closest pass to our Earth. A general indication of time is provided in the following screens of text. Please don't forget to like this video.